Hello and welcome to our method tutorial series on creating a basic app. In this video, we are going to look at conditional statements. That may sound daunting, but it's a fancy way for the computer to do different things based on a yes or no question. What do I mean by that? Well, we want the car name field to be required. So the question could be, is the field name filled? Depending on the answer, it will save or not save. Let's customize this screen so we can get this working. Go into the click event for the bottom save button. Search for conditional statement and add it in. You may notice this action looks a bit different, but you'll see why soon. Questions are asked in the form of conditional statements. We set up a scenario or a condition, and the computer sees if it's true or false. So, let's set up our condition. Click Add a Condition. We want to check the car name field. So in the first dropdown, find car name under the controls. To the right of that, change the dropdown to Is Not Empty. Condition is done. In the internal notes, type in if car name field is not empty. In other words, we're checking to see if the car name field is filled in. Oh, you may be wondering about if all the following are true, but don't worry about it for now. It will allow you to set up multiple conditions, but we only need one. So, how does this conditional statement work? We have the condition, car name field is not empty. If this is true, in other words, it was filled in, then it will do all the actions embedded underneath the if-then line. If it is false, in other words, the car name field is empty, then all the actions embedded within the else will be done. Of course, nothing is currently embedded, so it will make more sense if I set this up. I will hover over the line number of the save all action, and I will drag it underneath the if-then line. See how it becomes indented underneath? I will do the same with the call another action set. Great, so if car name is not empty, then it will do these two actions. If car name is empty, then it will do the actions after the else, which there's nothing there. So let me add one, a message to tell the user to fill in the car name. When I hover over the else line, I will see a plus sign, so I'll click that. On the right, I will search for show message, and then I will add it. Note how this show message action is now indented underneath the else line. I won't have to drag it in, it's there because I added an action using the plus sign on the else. Okay, let's fill in the show message for the header, car name required. And the message, please put in a car name, internal note, required car name. Great, we are done. So if the car name field is not empty, it will save the new record and go back. If the car name field is empty, it will show a message telling the user the field is required. We're done our conditional statement, but one last thing. Let me close the action editor and we'll preview this screen. We should let the user know that the car name field is required by putting an asterisk beside car name. Let me close the preview and select the car name field. I'll put an asterisk in at the beginning. Great, that's it. Let's save and close. Watch what happens when I click save with the car name empty. Ta-da! It gives me the warning and doesn't save. And we're pretty much finished with adding a car. So in our next few videos, we will focus on editing an existing car. Exciting! Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye!